Hi, I'm Joan Rivers. The name of the show, In Bed with Joan, and we start it the same way all the time. I look to the closet and I say, I wonder who's coming out of my closet today.
Ah! Yay!
Yay! Hey, Ellie Kemper.
Thank you.
How nice
thank
to
you.
Have you
oh.
on.
Should I take up?
Anything that makes you comfortable.
Okay, I'll sit.
Because it's this kind of a show.
Okay.
How are you?
Good, how are you?
I have watched you. How many years have you been on The Office? This is your last season.
This is the last season I've been on since season 5. So,
how did you get it? Did they call you to audition?
I had met the producers of the show when they were making a new show called Parks and Recreation. So yeah. I met them then. So that's how I got on their radar.
And you didn't get on?
Didn't get on Parks and Recreation. And then I got on The Office.
Yeah. Was it very upsetting not to get on Parks? And which came first?
Parks and Recreation was like announced first, but then this character came up in The Office a couple months later. So it worked out fine, you know.
And where were you living at the time?
Was living in New York. So you're familiar.
Yeah,
so
I know, I know. Well, actually, we're filming in New York, as you can see.
Oh, yeah, exactly. So yeah. I lived here. And then and then I moved to Los Angeles.
How old are you?
32.
How hard is it to move from New York to L.A., all new friends?
I know. Although a bunch of people were moving out at that same time, a bunch of my friends. And also, my younger sister lives here, or lived in Los Angeles.
So it made it
easier. That was a nice, yeah, that's good to have family there.
Because it all comes down to family.
Like, yeah.
Where do you spend Thanksgiving?
Mostly in St. Louis, because that's where I'm from. But this will be the first year because I just got married, so we'll be going to San Diego.
So why is there no ring?
Oh, there is. You just couldn't see it.
No, I couldn't.
It's his grandma's.
His grandma obviously didn't expect much. You're not Jews.
No, well, he is.
His grandmother was Jewish?
I think so, yeah. I think his grandmother was. Yes, I She was, yeah, she was. I think, yeah.
Well, once you're married, it's a whole different thing.
Yeah, right, yeah.
So friends, you know, we always are, who are your friends? Like, who have you gotten friendly with out here? Showbiz? Any showbiz friends?
Because
I have no friends.
I think you probably have
friends. No, I have a couple of friends that are not in show business.
Oh, I became friends with people who work on The Office with me.
Yeah.
You know, cast and crew there. Friends with Mindy Kaling.
She hates you.
I know.
She's been on this bed. She has trashed you.
She has torn you apart. That would be funny. I would love to hear what she said.
She said you are a bitch, conniving bitch. Did that bother you?
It didn't bother me because I know beneath that she really likes me. No, so Jenna Fisher is on the show.
Yeah.
I've become friends with her. Who else have I become friends with? I'm friends with
Who
should I just name all my friends?
No. We're on the internet.
Bob, Carol, Tracy. Think of names.
Who is that one friend? Because Melissa and I are going through a thing now about making amends with friends. Friends that you kind of had falling outs with. If there was one friend that you had, and no one watching this show, so you could talk freely. You know, it's very comforting to know.
It is nice in this bed.
It will go no further.
Okay, this bed. Okay.
Who, if you could, would you reach out into our camera and say, I'm sorry? Like, if I could, if I could get a hold of Winston Churchill, I would just say, I'm sorry I called you fatty. I'm sorry. Is there anybody that you would like to look into your heart and say, I'm sorry, and I'd like to make amends. Do you feel that? Yeah, you're too young.
I am. So, a real person?
Yeah.
Okay.
This is the time?
Okay, wait. Well, I mean, there was a girl in third grade, Jenny Sleeper, that I spilled some glue, and I blamed it on her, and I never told, and the teacher yelled at her for being, you know, messy with her stuff and the glue, and I let her take it, and I never, I never.
That is
you know, Ellie, the audience has just turned against you.
I know that, and then we have Mindy already trashing me. I have to work my way back out of this hole.
Would you like to turn to the camera and apologize to her now?
Jenny Sleeper, I don't know if you've gotten married and have a new last name now.
Or still alive.
Oh, gosh. she could be dead.
In a three-way with a sailor. She was a whore even in third grade.
Even in third grade. She said it, not me, Jenny. I would like to apologize for putting the blame of the glue on you. If you're still alive.
You feel better. Yay.
I feel better. I feel better.
Won the audience's hearts back.
Yay! Thank you, guys.
Okay, so this is your last season in the office.
Mm-hmm.
So what happens now? All the jokes are like, well, the next year we'll do unemployment office, right? Are you getting all those stupid jokes?
Yeah, right. Like, that'll be the new, that'll be the new one. I don't have any plans for next year yet, so I don't know what I'll do. But
well, you're married.
I'm married, so maybe
thank
I'll
God.
Just, yeah, thank God I have that.
Thank God you thank thank God you have that. But, are they getting sad?
People are getting sad. Yeah, because when Steve Carell left the office, which was about 2 years ago, people got sad then. And now it's like that all over again.
And how does it end? Do you all die?
We all die.
Have they figured out the ending?
I think the writers maybe have, but I don't know.
They haven't told you yet?
They haven't told us yet. I personally hope it ends a little darkly.
It should be like a terrible industrial accident.
Yeah.
Oh,
That's very The Office.
Yeah,
it needs to go dark.
A terrible industrial
accident.
Maybe it'll die just maimed. Did you feel the earthquake last night?
I did feel the earthquake last night.
Were you terrified? Aren't you terrified? Because you're not from here.
I'm not from here, so I'm not used to earthquakes. I grew up in St. Louis, where the New Madrid fault line is like 200 miles south, and so that was always a big fear. In 1989, I think it was, Ivan Browning predicted like the biggest earthquake
ever
of the like world.
Right.
Yeah. On December 3rd, so everyone stayed home from school. I didn't stay home from school.
And what is little Jenny
Jenny Sleeper. Jenny Sleeper's the type who would have stayed home from school.
She was still cleaning up the glue.
Exactly right. She thought that was bad. She didn't know the earthquake.
She could have blamed her on the earthquake.
It wasn't me, Mrs. Graves.
It was the earthquake. Mrs. Graves?
Mrs. Graves was
some
her name.
Some name.
I know, that was her name. As she said, Mrs. Graves asked me what my favorite TV show was in third grade, and it was The Golden Girls. And Mrs. Graves was like, that's too old for you.
That's not for you, Mrs. Graves. All right, so what did you do in the earthquake? Do you get under the bed? What do you do?
Well, last night felt so, like, it was worrisome, but then it was over. But so I think I just woke up panicked. But I don't know, actually. I'm not prepared earthquake-wise,
Nor am I.
No.
Well, I'm older, so my vagina has dropped, which is a good thing. Because I suction myself to the ground.
Oh, that's out. I was wondering how that would help you. Okay. Oh, so then you're safe.
I am safe.
And flexible.
And flexible. You studied in London.
Yeah, in Oxford. Yes.
Outside of London.
Same difference. And I studied there for a year. And the best part was I did some acting there with the Oxford, like, you know, student groups. So that was fun.
What did you do? What were the plays?
I was in a children's play, actually. I was in a bunch of stuff. A lot of them were original. It wasn't like Shakespeare. But I was in a show called The Glass Slipper or The White Slipper. And we went to Edinburgh to the Fringe Festival.
So excited.
But you are doing, like, comedy shows, and I was doing a children's show.
17 one-nighters all over England, which is great, and UK.
Wait, hold on. You were just
Ireland.
There, but you were just came back.
I just came back.
She's talking about when
now.
You were in Edinburgh when my mom was in Edinburgh.
Well, I don't know if I was there the same year, but I know that you have been
to Edinburgh Festival. Yeah.
Okay, let's go back to the White Slipper,
which
is kind of a stupid name.
Very stupid.
As we know, it should have been GLASS. Who did you play?
I know we should have. Oh my gosh. This is so long ago that now I can't remember who I played. It was really like an ensemble piece, so I feel like it was, oh my God. I was like a princess, I guess.
Do you remember any lines?
I'm such a good actress. I don't remember any lines.
Did you feel princess?
I felt princessy. The best part of being there was going around to go see these shows, these comedy shows and stuff. That was the best part of being there.
Explain to our audience, I don't know which camera is our,
that
okay,
camera?
It is Ellie camera. In Edinburgh, they perform from 10 o'clock in the morning on.
Yeah.
And you get a list of everybody that's performing in Edinburgh.
Mm-hmm.
And you go, you start checking all the ones you want to see. It's so exciting.
Yeah, it's so exciting. And you are performing every night.
I've done three times. I performed every night. Three different times I've been there. But you just run around to see everybody.
Yeah.
It's so much
it's
fun.
It's so cool. It's like camp or something.
It's like theatrical camp.
Theatrical camp. And it's such a great time of year to be there. It's such a gorgeous city. And in August, it's just beautiful. Yeah.
Did you always want to be an actress?
No. First, I wanted to be a nun. Because I love The Sound of Music.
Are you Catholic?
Yeah.
Okay, because that helps.
Yeah, it does help. That was my first in. Yeah. And then I wanted to be a teacher. But then after I graduated, I thought, I'm going to move to New York. So, no, it wasn't. No, it wasn't.
So how did
you knew. Oh, sorry.
From the from the beginning, I knew. But when did you suddenly realize I want to be an actress? When did it go from nun to actress?
Nun to actress. It's a common transition.
Yeah.
When I started doing improv comedy in college, I was like, oh, I love this. And I actually felt like I was good at it. So yeah. I decided I want to keep doing this. It was. Yeah.
And were your parents happy?
Yeah, they were. They were fine with it. They were. I think my dad sort of thought, oh, she'll give it a whirl for a couple years.
Because you went to Princeton. I mean, it's not like you were a stupid kid. They must have thought you were doing something better, you know?
I think, oh, yeah, no.
Acting is not like what people want their children to
not
do.
Not why you paid money to educate them. Exactly, right. But then if it turns out.
But
you are responsible and hardworking, and then.
Did you like Princeton? What'd you major in?
English.
Yeah, I like it. 1, 2, 3, squeals. I love. Martha Stewart also, 1, 2, 3. You played hockey,
Field hockey there.
Lesbianism, rampant.
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 Do you know what I said once to my coach? I said, she asked if my mom was athletic. And I said, not like, she just said, did your mom play field hockey? Like, was she athletic? I said, no, she was really more of a thespian. And I was like, a thespian!
I had to sleep. With a woman, mm-hmm. any woman in the whole world, Helen Mirren.
Oh.
Because A, my body would be better than hers. Already, so that's a start, which I like. And two, she's English. She would say, I have arrived. It would just be better. And we could lie in bed afterwards and say, oh, darling, you'd be so great as Lady Macbeth. No, you'd be so great as Lady Macbeth. You would be better as Lady Macbeth than me. It would be so wild. Who would you, if you had to save your family, had to save your husband,
yes.
You have to sleep with one woman or the whole world's going to collapse.
Okay,
Ellie.
Okay. And it all depends on me. Precious.
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 Because?
Good meal at the end. Right?
You are so adorable. If you ever go on Ellen.
Yes. Wait. I'm going on Tuesday.
Do not mention you played field hockey. And flash your pathetic way.
I can't wait to tell Michael, because I've given him, I won't say that.
No, say it.
I've given him grief.
Well, you shouldn't give him grief.
Also, I'm embarrassed because I burned my hand, and so I don't want to show
it. Well, I hope that's not from cooking.
It is from cooking. Well, do you think I'm just chained to the, boy, have I become a wife too fast?
You're getting a wife too fast. You never cook. You're an actress.
Oh.
You do what you do best.
I'm taking that. You. I just am storing that away.
Yes.
Wait, thank you.
You don't cook. You don't.
I won't cook.
You should expect nothing domestic from you.
Great.
You're an actor.
Actor.
What do you think about the asses that, well, that's kind of leading the question, that call themselves, I am an actor, not an actress.
Oh, yeah, I know. I have no problem calling myself an actress.
Right.
But I have a question. You're not a, do you refer to yourself as a comedian or comedian? Do you do
whore.
Comedian?
Funny whore. No, I always say I'm a comedian. A comedian, I guess.
D-I-A-N.
But it's different with us because
we
get no respect. You know what I mean? No, my mother, to the day she died, would not say I was a comedian.
What?
She would say she's a writer.
A writer and
she
actress.
Would tell other people she's an actress. She's
Wait,
a
performer.
Writer.
Performer.
Yeah. She would never say she's a comic.
Why?
Because look who's comics. Jackie O, you know. Hey, nun and a rabbi were walking into a bar. It's not what she wanted.
It's not what she wanted, but that's also not, okay, I see. I have no, as far as actress or waitress, or what's another one?
Waitress is good.
Waitress is good, or even stewardess.
I like stewardess.
So you're all for it. I mean,
still call stewardesses, even the men.
Oh.
And That's obvious. But they don't mind. When you're being served with a guy who's wearing ballet slippers, it's stewards.
It's okay.
How did you meet a straight man?
Oh, he, you know what? He wrote on Late Night with Conan O'Brien.
Oh, so he's funny.
He's so funny. He is so, well, as a side note, I'll tell you later.
No, tell us.
Well,
tell
no, he's so, he was working, he was, I didn't even ask for clearance if he could come, but he was going to come. And anyway, but he worked until 5 a.m. and he was too tired. He is funny. He wrote on Late Night with Conan O'Brien, and I did little like bits on the show,
right.
Acting on it, and so that's how we met. And then, so that's how I met him, and he happened to be straight. So
how great! And how good to have him in this town. It's like surprise.
I'm not kidding. Yeah, right.
Yeah. It's very hard. Does he know anybody from Melissa?
Mom.
All right. I'm sorry. I'm just asking. Just asking. You've been just a joy and a pleasure.
Oh, thank you so much.
Joy and a pleasure.
This has been a joy and a pleasure.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, guys. Thank
you. Ellie Kemper, ladies and gentlemen.
Friends with people who work on The Office with me.
Yeah.
Friends with Mindy Kaling.
Jeez. What's her name?
Jenny Sleeper.
Little slut. Great name.
Great name.
Perfect name for you, Jenny, if you know what I mean.
I'm not prepared earthquake-wise,
nor
actually.
Nor are you?
No.
Well, I'm older, so my vagina has dropped.
But how does that?
I suction myself to the ground.
Oh, that sounds...